Richard Wright, and welcome to Right Now News, where we deliver the right news the right way. I'm Amali Anurkanova, and we are back for the 2021-2022 school year. Woo! So far, we witnessed groundbreaking historical moments and winning streaks. All that and more coming your way.
High schools are making a comeback in Southwest D.C. It has been nearly 50 years since the Southwest community of Washington, D.C. has had a high school. Randall Junior High School first opened its doors in 1906. The purpose of Randall Junior High was to meet the educational needs of African Americans in the Southwest community during the era of segregation. The building closed in 1978 and is now a historical building located on 65 I Street Southwest. It also served as a homeless shelter back in 2004. Now in 2021, a new high school is in town. Richard Wright Public Charter Schools for Journalism and Media Arts has made its way from Southeast to Southwest, providing the Southwest community with a superb education focusing on journalism and media arts. The official ribbon cutting for the new RWPCS building took place on Friday, September 17, 2021. Community partners and leaders from all over the city came to celebrate as they brought in the new decade with a monumental event. Thank you, Dr. Clark, for committing to your vision and the betterment of students in Washington, D.C. I'm Destiny Whittington for Right Now News.
You've seen part one, and this year we've covered part two, answering all of your concerns and winning together.
Richard Wright Public Charter School is making its mission to impact beyond the campus grounds. Last Tuesday, we held part two of the citywide forum, Let's Win Together. This forum allows the community to become aware of the myths and the facts of the coronavirus vaccine, while also addressing any concerns someone may have about the virus in general.
One of the ways we can protect our young people, number one, is making sure that if we are eligible to get vaccinated, that we consider that, because that can be protection. In addition to that, we gotta make sure that we model to them wearing masks. And that is very important, because too many times you see people not wearing a mask, or they wearing it under their nose. And if you're wearing it like this, you might as well not even wear a mask.
In the part two session, the audience had many thought-provoking questions for Dr. Jadan Phillips. Those concerning the different types of vaccines, the new age limit for youth, and boosters too.
We have seen now that the Delta variant, which is over 95% of the cases that we're seeing each day, are the Delta variant. The Delta variant is much more infectious as far as its ability to infect yourself and other people than the Alpha variant, which was the original strain that we saw last year. Again, the good thing is that the vaccines and the booster shots still seem to have very good effectiveness in protecting you against the Delta variant. In addition to that, you've got the Lambda and the Mu variant, which are a couple that are of the newer. These are not yet concerning, they're just more of interest, because we have not seen great numbers of them just yet. If we want to fight against these variants, the vaccines have shown to still be effective in preventing against the most common variant that we're seeing, which is the Delta. And the way that we stop the multiplying or the increased number of these variants is we've got to get vaccinated, we've got to make sure that we wear masks and doing all these other safety measures.
As always, Dr. Phillips was able to address the facts and clear up the myths. Overall, part two was a major success. Huge thank you to Dr. Clark, Dr. Phillips, and the entire Roxy team. I'm Skyly Johnson for Right Now News.
The Lady Spartans have hit the ground running, dominating the courts. Here's the story.
The Richard Wright PCS volleyball team is on a winning streak, taking the courts by storm, winning 4, losing 0. Lady Spartans spiked the first game by beating our rivals, Cesar Chavez High School, in a 2-0 game. Recently, the team has won against E.L. Haynes PCS, winning another 2-0 game. Way to rock the house, Lady Spartans. I'm Ray Tyson for Right Now News.
Well, that's all for this episode of WNN. I'm Amalia Nurkanova, signing off for Right Now News. Bye!